Yo, what's good, everybody? It is your boy, Big Tit Joe, and we're coming at you guys today with my NHL 2021 to 2022 season predictions. And these predictions will range from award winners such as the Hart Trophy and the Selke to who I think is going to win the Stanley Cup. And let's waste no time and get right into the predictions. First trophy we will look at is the Norris Trophy, which is awarded to the best defenseman of the season. Last year's winner was Adam Fox of the New York Rangers. However, I do not see that happening again. I do not think Adam Fox is going to win the Norris again. Instead, I will think it will be another first-time Norris Trophy winner, and that will be Cale Makar of the Colorado Avalanche. I mean, he is a phenomenal defenseman. He's probably the best defenseman in the league, if not the second best. I would probably agree if you say Victor Hem is currently the best, and given in maybe a year or two, Cale's the best. I completely agree with that assessment, and I definitely think Cale's already one of the best, and he's not even touched his peak yet. I think he's going to start reaching, definitely keep getting better and growing every year, and that's why I think this will be the start of him winning many, many, many Norris trophies. And then the runner-ups, I think, will be Ryan Pelech of the New York Islanders and Victor Hedman, the Tampa Bay Lightning. I mean, you can't leave off Hedman. He's obviously one of the best defensemen in the league. Can't leave him off. All right, the next trophy we'll look into is the Calder Trophy. And the favorite to win this is Cole Caulfield. But I don't have Cole Caulfield winning. I have Trevor Zegras winning the Calder Trophy. Now, I know this is most people are saying, oh, it's Cole Caulfield. It's definitely going to be Cole. It's definitely going to be Cole. Ain't no way it's going to be Cole. Look at Trevor. Trevor is going to be an animal. He is going to be the guy that's going to be the main focus on the Anaheim team. Last year he played a little bit, but he is going to be the guy in Anaheim. There ain't no way. He's going to be the guy that they're going to set up the offense around this year. And he was playing very good last year. And he technically, I would say that was his rookie year. But technically, he did not, that wasn't his rookie year. This year will be his first rookie year since it would be technically his first full year. Listen, I don't make up the rules. This is what the NHL says, but I think Trevor Zegras is going to win and Cole Caulfield is the other runner-up. I couldn't think of another runner-up, so I'm just going to leave it blank. No point. Now, the next trophy we'll look into is the Selke Trophy, which is rewarded to the best offensive defenseman, meaning a two-way forward. Who's the best two-way forward in the league? Last year's winner was Alexander Barkov of the Florida Panthers, who just signed a massive extension, which was a phenomenal signing for the Florida Panthers and was much needed, especially with that team and how they're looking. They look very good this year. Do not sleep on the Florida Panthers. We'll touch on that in a moment, though. However, do I think he'll have the same fortune this year? No. I think Mark Stone of the Vegas Golden Knights will win it this year. After what I saw last year, Stone, he just got better as the year went on, and he became the best player in Vegas on that offensive, on the offense. He looked very, very good last year, and he still doesn't have the center. And he became the focal point around that Vegas Golden Knights roster last year and became their pretty much their best player. And last year, he finished second in the voting for the Selke Trophy behind Barkov, who I have being runner-up. And behind him, behind Barkov for runner-up, I have Sean Couturier of the Philadelphia Flyers, who was the 2020 Selke Trophy winner. And now we're going to look at the Jack Adams Trophy, which is the Coach of the Year. And I, the guy I have winning that, it is the Barry Trotz, might be one of the best coaches in the NHL. I mean, the things he's going to do with the Islanders team this year with the players that they got will be fantastic. And the runner-ups I have with that is Joel Quenneville and Sheldon Keefe of the Toronto Maple Leafs coach. I think the Leafs might bounce back, but we'll talk about that in a moment. Now let's go to the Hart Trophy, which is the MVP. Last year's winner, obviously, is Connor McJesus. I mean, the year he had last year was insane. Unreal, unhuman. It was an insane year. One of the best seasons I've ever seen from a player. And I'm repeating again. Now, do I think he'll have a good enough season like he did last year? No, I don't think he'll be just, I don't think he'll be as good as he was last year, but I still think he's going to be obviously the best player in the league, because it's Connor McDavid. There's nothing short of brilliance when he plays, and every time he steps on the ice, he's a game changer every time. He is. Him and Trisotto are the Edmonton Oilers. And it is insane what he can do. And yeah, I have him winning again this year, and then the runner-ups being Nikita Kucherov and Nathan MacKinnon. And then the last award we will look at is the Vezina Trophy Award, which is awarded to the best goalie every year. And the winner I have for that will be a first-time winner of the Vezina, who I think should have probably won it last year over Marc-Andre Fleury, Andre Vasilevsky. It is kind of crazy how Vasilevsky didn't win last year. I guess it kind of made sense that Fleury won, but I still think Vazzy was the best goalie last year. And Vazzy, I think, will win this year because he is a phenomenal goaltender and the best goaltender in the league. And no doubt in my mind, he'll win a Vezina soon. I think it'll be this year. And then the runner-ups for the Vezina will be Darcy Kuemper of the Colorado Avalanche. I think that Avalanche defense is going to help him so much. And Darcy is a very, very underrated goaltender. I love the pickup that Colorado got out of Darcy Kuemper. And I think he's going to be a fantastic goaltender for Colorado. And then the other runner-up I have will be Connor Hellebuyck out of the Winnipeg Jets. Top 3 goaltender in the league. Easily. He's a phenomenal goalie, and he's going to have another great year this year.
And now let's look at the NHL division predictions I have for this upcoming season. And we'll start out in the Western Conference with the weakest division in the NHL, known as the Pacific Division. And here are my predictions. 8th, I have the Anaheim Ducks. 7th, I have the San Jose Sharks. 6th, the LA Kings. 5th, the Seattle Kraken. Now, I don't think Seattle's going to be that good. I did take these predictions before the game, their first game. Obviously, this video is coming out after the first game of the season. However, that had no influence on my pick. I had this pick already set and done for a while and where they're seated at. I don't see them being that great, as good as Vegas. Goaltending, I don't think Grubauer is going to be as good. He doesn't have the Colorado defense in front of him. He's not going to be as good. And this team, they're not simply not as good as Vegas. Their defense is strong. Goaltending looks fine. Scoring, but yes, they did come back last night. However, I still don't see them as a team that's, they're going to probably be a playoff contender. I think they might be right outside the playoff bubble. Yeah, I can see that, but I don't think they're going to do any damage, though. That's what I'm trying to get at. So, 4th, I have the Vancouver Canucks, meaning I think they're going to bounce back, but still not make playoffs. And then teams that are going to make the playoffs in the Pacific are the Calgary Flames, Edmonton Oilers, and the Vegas Golden Knights. I'd be silly to have anyone else but Vegas in first in the division. I'd be stupid. That division's so weak. I think the gap between first to second is large between Vegas and Edmonton. Now, in the Central Division, here are my predictions. 8th, I have the Arizona Coyotes. 7th, the Nashville Predators. 6th, the St. Louis Blues. I don't know why, but I think the St. Louis Blues are going to struggle this year. I mean, they made some nice additions this offseason, but I am not very, very... It's not that I don't think they're going to be good. It's that I think some of the teams are going to bounce back years this year in the Central that are going to do better than them. And then 5th, I have the Chicago Blackhawks. Yes, bold prediction. I think Chicago is going to beat out St. Louis and make a playoff spot. That is pretty bold, but I think it's going to happen. I think Chicago's got a decent team. They're going to be led by Jonathan Tate coming back and Patty Kane, Brincat, and Kirby Dack. Yeah, I do like Chicago this year. 4th, Minnesota. 3rd, Winnipeg Jets. 2nd, the Dallas Stars. I still really like Dallas. After, yes, the weird year last year with COVID and all the injury problems, I think Dallas will bounce back. And 1st, obviously the Colorado Avalanche, one of the favorites to win the Cup, obviously. Yeah, I think it's pretty obvious, Colorado first. Now, in the Eastern Conference, we'll start out with the Atlantic Division, and here is my predictions. 8th, the Buffalo Sabres. 7th, the Detroit Red Wings. 6th, the Ottawa Senators. 5th, the Montreal Canadiens, the team that made the Stanley Cup Final last year, are not making playoffs this year. Very interesting, however, there's going to be injury problems at the beginning of the year. Carey Price is missing a significant amount of time. I do not think they're going to be contenders or even make playoffs this year. And 4th, I have the Boston Bruins. 3rd, the Florida Panthers. 2nd, the Tampa Bay Lightning. And 1st, the Toronto Maple Leafs. I am very high on the Maple Leafs this year, simply due to the fact that they kept that core intact. And that is what Tampa did when they got upsetted by Columbus and got swept. They kept the core intact. gained more chemistry because they were there together last year. They made some nice, good key acquisitions like Andre Kasha and I think Nick Ritchie. Yeah, Nick Ritchie. They're very, very good additions to the team. It's going to help the depth of that team. And I really, really like Toronto this year. And in the Metropolitan, I have, and here's my predictions, 8th, the Columbus Blue Jackets, 7th, the New Jersey Devils, 6th, the Pittsburgh Penguins. Yes, I think the Penguins are going to struggle this year due to injury concerns. Not really their playing capability, injury concerns. And then how is Jari going to play the whole year? Yes, they won game 1 against Tampa Bay. Tampa looked dead, though. How are they going to look for the rest of the season? And that was their B team, so I'll give Pittsburgh props, but I think they're going to have a lot of injury problems that's going to hurt them this year. 5th, I have the New York Rangers. 4th, the Washington Capitals. 3rd, the Philadelphia Flyers. It's because they make and miss playoffs every other year. They're so off and on, and this is the years that they usually make the playoffs. It's the even years. Since 2012, it's been this way. So, yeah, I have the Flyers make a playoff simply due to that fact and how they retooled this year. I really, really like how the Flyers look this year. And hopefully, and Carter Hart bounces back, which I think he will. He has had a very, very solid preseason when he has played. He's looked very, very good when he played in preseason so far. Yet again, that is preseason, so take that with a grain of salt. 2nd, the Carolina Hurricanes. And 1st, the New York Islanders. I really, really like the Islanders this year, and I think they're going to be contenders for the Stanley Cup this year. And now I'm going to pick the teams I think that are all going to make the conference finals this year, meaning teams are going to be the last four remaining in the NHL this upcoming season. And we'll start in the Western Conference. I have Colorado and Vegas being the teams that make it to the conference finals for the Western Conference finals. I mean, Colorado, juggernaut team, Vegas in a Mickey Mouse specific division. I think Vegas making it is a no-brainer. However, it's the playoffs, anything can happen. Colorado, I think they finally get past the second round and make the third round. And then in the Eastern Conference, I have quite the bold call here. I have the Toronto Maple Leafs and the New York Islanders in the conference finals for the Eastern Conference. I think it's Toronto's year. If Toronto gets past the first round, I think they can do it. I literally think Toronto can do it. If they get past the first round, Toronto will go on a deep run. You can book it to the bank. I can guarantee it. The year they get past the first round, they are going deep because they're going to get that chip off their shoulder and they're going to play hungry and they're going to play really damn good that year. Whenever that may be, 94 or whenever that year might be, they're going to play hungry and determined, and they're going to be really good when they finally get past that first round. And I think that's gonna be this year, because they kept that core intact, they kept good chemistry. They're gonna have good chemistry this year because they were all from last year, besides maybe two of them. They're gonna be very helpful to the team, and I've loved what they've done. I think they're gonna do it this year. And so my Stanley Cup final prediction, I have the Colorado Avalanche and, I think you guessed it, the Toronto Maple Leafs. And no, I'm not a Toronto fan if you ask. No. But I think Toronto is going to go deep this year. And riding the wave, I think the Colorado Avalanche will win the Stanley Cup. Nah, I'm not going that far where I think Toronto's going to win the Cup. However, Colorado just looks too damn good. I mean, people are kind of doubting them this year, even if they are the Stanley Cup favorites for betting odds. A lot of people still aren't taking them. I mean, I really, really, really like Colorado this year. And I think they're finally going to do it and get that first ring and just win more. I think they're going to be a very, very good team throughout this decade and probably maybe win more multiple cups after if they can win this one. So that is my NHL 2021 to 2022 season predictions. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time.